Yeah, after the first round, like we said, we knew the priority to solve was our defensive behavior. But we let in too many goals, except the match Arema, like I said, I've given an excuse for that. But the others were let in too many goals. And you saw that the priority to work on the defensive behavior paid off. We already know on the plus, we know more minus, we plus, we kept a couple of clean sheets. But in terms of finishing, we can still be more effective. We still need quite a number of opportunities before we score goals. We need to be more efficient, and that is something that is a progress. We're working on that. We got some very tough matches ahead of us as well. If you think now the first match with a good attacking team like Semarang. So we have to be very efficient in how we attack in order to score more goals than they will score. They are a team that is capable of scoring goals. Yeah, we got a lot of options, and you know the rule normally is you don't change your winning team too much, but we need to take in consideration we got 8 players on yellow cards. We need to take in consideration recovery and after injuries players, and so it's a lot of things because we have not been able to train. Must not forget when players are not playing, there's hardly any training. We've been traveling, we have been recovering, so the players only can train again and then show that they're ready for a possibility to come into the match again. Well, the mentality of the players is good. If you look at the matches that we played, if the referees are fair, which is still an important factor, and I keep reminding about it, because we all have seen when it is not fair, the team is on a stable run, and we are already getting in better positions, which is the target as well, but we got tough matches ahead, so the mentality of the players is already top class. That motivation factor is already within themselves.
Pagi persiapan terakhir kita untuk menjelang pertandingan melawan Semarang. Kita tahu Semarang tim yang kuat. Saya berharap tren positif ini tetap berlanjut dan berharap dukungan Bobotoh memenuhi stadion besok. Karena itu penting untuk pemain. Saya berharap ke semua Bobotoh, saudaraku dimanapun kalian berada, selalu menjaga ketertiban, jaga perdamaian, karena kita tahu kalian ada Bobotoh yang dewasa semua, insya Allah, saling menjaga demi kelancaran dan baik untuk tim kita juga kalau kalian damai. Oh, 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 oh